Men and women united through collective bargaining agreements.
We earn family supporting pay, good benefits, and the opportunity for advancement and better lives. Do you?
To learn more about the Laborers International Union of North America, go to liuna.org.
Hi, I'm Julia Roberts.
And I'm Bruce Willis.
In 1988, our dear friend Paul Newman had a vision, a place where kids with serious illnesses could just be kids.
So he founded a camp, and the joy of playing, laughing, and simply belonging had a profound effect.
Freeing the children to reach beyond their illnesses and discover new strength.
From that one camp, the Serious Fund Children's Network has grown, serving 30,000 kids globally every year.
At no cost to their families.
Learn more about the Serious Fund camp closest to you. Visit flyinghorsefarms.org.
It is the Jeff Santos Show that you're tuned into. Let's talk to a good friend of ours from the great city of Seattle. Works for a great number of great websites. Our good friend Mark Taylor Canfield joins us. How you doing, Mark?
Hey, Jeff. Good to talk to you again. How are you doing?
Good. Good to talk to you, my friend. I can imagine you must have been out there in Seattle with some protests and so forth. I was out last night here in Boston. What's it like in Seattle these days?
Sleepless in Seattle. I've had maybe 2 hours sleep in the last 48 hours.
Wow.
Just covering these protests as a freelancer and also over at Daily Coast. I'm writing about it. But there have been some major protests here, and there is an issue related to the situation in Ferguson I'd really like folks to know about.
And go for it.
We can always, you know, we can always talk about this in more detail on a future program, especially how it relates to the national issue. But, of course, you know, there have been major protests here in Seattle over the last 2 days with police using pepper spray and flashbang grenades on Monday night, actually, at a protest near Interstate 5. And then last night, 2,000 people blocked the streets. But there's a reason, Jeff, why this issue is so important to civil rights activists in Seattle and to everyone in Seattle. And I know you and I have talked before about the 8-month Department of Justice investigation of the Seattle Police Department, in which they found a policy of the use of excessive force and profiling. But today there is a very shocking article in the Seattle Times that I'd like to draw people's attention to. And it asks a very serious question. You would think that in a progressive city like Seattle, we wouldn't have problems with the police department like they have in Ferguson. But Danny Westney wrote today in the Seattle Times and asked this question. Actually, he makes a statement. The banner headline is, "We're no better than Ferguson, maybe worse." And that is a really, really shocking article to come from a mainstream newspaper like the Seattle Times. So creds to Danny for being so courageous to write about this. But the story in Seattle goes back to John T. Williams, who was a Native American wood carver back in 2010. He was killed by Officer Ian Burke. The wood carver apparently was not aggressive, but no charges were filed. And even U.S. Attorney Jenny Durkan this week in the Washington Post compared that case to the Ferguson case. So it's really left a big mark on the community. There have already been a lot of police brutality protests in Seattle. Folks actually carved a huge totem pole and carried it down to Pike Place Market and erected it there to memorial to John T. Williams. But that is not the only case. There is also the case of Christopher Harris, a completely innocent man who mistakenly ran from police in 2009, was shoved into a wall so hard that it paralyzed him for life. That officer not only wasn't charged, but remained on the force. And then there's the case of Troy Mead, an Everett police officer who shot a drunken driver, Miles Merzervi, 7 times from behind. And the officer
was so
questionable that even his fellow officer actually crossed the thin blue line, so to speak, and spoke out against that.
Yeah, you know, when we've just been talking about this with some other callers and so forth on this issue. Is there a difference? I mean, I know there is a difference in different police forces. Seattle had the issues with the back at the Y2K period at the turn of the century. For different protests and stuff, has it improved? And is it more down to the suburban, much like Ferguson? You mentioned Everett. These suburban police departments, which for years were all white, and when they have to integrate, it becomes a major problem. Is that what you're seeing in what is a progressive Seattle metropolitan area?
Well, not necessarily, because although there have, ever since the WTO demonstrations, there have been examples of suburban cops, you know, using force on protesters, especially when they're called in during big protests under the mutual aid agreement amongst the Seattle Police Department and its other agencies. But, you know, we have a new police chief here, Kathleen O'Toole, who's the former police commissioner from Boston, and she was also involved in the National Police Reform Commission in Ireland. And she was brought in by our mayor, Ed Murray, to clean house and force these reforms that the Justice Department wants so badly the Seattle Police Department to adopt. But immediately, 100 officers filed a lawsuit against the mayor and against U.S. Attorney General Eric Holder to try to stop those reforms. So it's not just the suburbs. There's just a perception.
Just a lot of pushback.
There's a perception in the community that the Seattle Police Department does practice racial profiling. There is direct evidence of that in the prosecution of the city's marijuana ordinance, which, even though it's legal in Washington State, it's actually not legal, you know, to smoke outside of businesses downtown and things like that. But predominantly, the majority of people who have been charged under that ordinance since it was adopted, 80% have been young black males.
Wow.
So it is a
let's do this in the next couple of weeks. I'd love to check up, and I'm really glad, too, that, of course, you know, Seattle has led the way in other regards on the minimum wage. So thank you, my friend. Great to hear from you. Have yourself a great Thanksgiving holiday.
You, too. Have a great holiday, everyone. We'll talk to you soon, Jeff.
Mark Taylor Canfield here on the Jeff Santos Show. Let's end the all the best, Yogi. I want to thank Michelle, who has written on Facebook to wish all of us, including myself, thank you, Michelle, for that great message.